फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू गीतास किचन। टुडेज एपिसोड इज स्पेशली फॉर ऑल द बिगिनर्स हु हैव जस्ट स्टार्टेड आउट ऑन हैविंग देयर ओन किचन, बाइंग थिंग्स फॉर देयर हाउस होल्ड्स एंड एनीबडी हु वुड लाइक टू सेव टाइम एंड डू योर किचन ग्रोसरी शॉपिंग इन अ वेरी प्लान्ड मैनर। वेरी ऑफन इट हैपन्स दैट वी थिंक ऑफ shopping for grocery, then when we come back we say, oh, I forgot this item, or then you come back and realize you already have a particular item and then you have bought it without realizing. So today what I'm going to share with you is like a ready reckoner for Indian vegetarian cookery, both for South Indian as well as North Indian. So have a look at this so that you can plan your monthly grocery shopping accordingly. See, it is always better for you to have a list with you before you go shopping. This way you will be able to plan your groceries very well. And generally if you buy things for a month, you need not go repeatedly to the store to purchase things. So how I have made it is, I have made classified it into different columns. The first one I have taken as beverages. Now this is what we need as soon as we get up in the morning. So under beverages we need sugar, coffee, tea, and maybe some of you might be buying some health drinks also. These are left to individual choices. So this is what you will require, and the amounts that you need, it depends on the number of persons in your household. For a small family of two, I would say you can take about 2 kgs of sugar, 1/2 kg of coffee if you drink filter coffee, another 1/2 kg of tea. Those who need to buy green tea or lemon tea, remember to add that to your list, and also any health drinks in case you need them. Next, basically if your main meals consist majorly of rice, then you will need a larger quantity of raw rice. Then I have also added idli rice, which is parboiled rice for making idlis and dosas. And then just about 1 kg of basmati rice whenever you want to make a fluffy pulao where you can have nice long grain rice. So if it is a family which uses mainly rice, you can buy about 10 kg of raw rice, 2 kg of idli rice and 1 kg of basmati rice. Next we want to see the different dals that we require. Being vegetarians, for us dals are the main source of protein, so you must see that you include some form of dal, either whole or split, in your diet. So for that I have taken tuvar dal, which is red gram dal, urad dal, moong dal and chana dal. Tuvar dal you can take about 2 kgs, urad dal and moong dal 1 kg each, and chana dal 1/2 kg, because we really don't use this much except for maybe when you want to make vadas or adai. And then also add these whole pulses, that is kabuli chana, rajma and whole green moong. You can buy 1/2 kg of each of these. Now every month it is not necessary to buy all these three, chana, rajma and moong. You buy these and see how much is left over. If you have consumed it, you can again buy. Otherwise, depending on your consumption, you can see. But this helps you to rotate your menus and add wide variety. You can have rice and rajma one day instead of just having sambar. So this will make it very interesting. Next, coming to the flours. As I said, if you are a majorly rice eating person, then I told you to take 10 kgs of rice. But if you eat more of chapatis, then you can have 5 kgs of atta and reduce your quantity of rice. Or if you eat only rice, then you can 2 kgs of atta will do. That depends on your personal choice. Apart from that, you should buy 1 kg of rice flour, another kilo of gram flour or besan, and also maida or all-purpose flour. These will come in handy for various preparations, whether for breakfast or dinner items or snacks. All these, if they are handy in the kitchen at any time, even when you feel hungry or some guests suddenly drop in, you can make items easily. Then the next column I have given as breakfast items. Here I have taken suji rava, then poha or aval or avalaki, semia or vermicelli, and of course ground nuts, and chutney dal or puttani dal, roasted gram, potukadlai, different names for the same.
So all these rava, avil and vermicelli you can buy 1 kg of each and half a kg of groundnuts and say about a quarter kg of this chutney dal or roasted gram. Next essential item are the oils which we use. We have to use a variety of oils. One is your main cooking oil which you use for all your cooking. I generally use refined sunflower oil. So whatever you are accustomed to, sunflower oil or groundnut oil, you can buy about 2 packets. A small quantity, say about 100 ml of coconut oil for your curd based gravies. And thin oil also 100 ml I have added, because when you want to use the idli molaga podi or for making dosas, thin oil adds a very good flavor. Next I have written as puja oil. This puja oil is used for lighting the lamp. So those of you who have the habit of lighting the lamp and doing some prayers in the morning and evening, you will need this puja oil, which is very easily available under different brand names as Deepam etc. You can buy that. Apart from that, you will need some butter if you are going to melt it and make it into ghee, or you can buy ghee directly. Again, you can buy say about half a kg of this. Apart from this, you need items for your seasoning. Indian cookery always calls a lot of seasoning, condiments and spices. So for that I have taken mustard seeds, jeera or cumin seeds, methi seeds, asafoetida, that is hing. All these you can just buy about 100 grams of each. Then dry red chilies, also 100 grams will do. Coriander seeds, same. And then thil or white sesame seed, small quantity will do, say 50 grams. And omam or ajwain, which we use in making our parathas, which makes them very flavorful. So all these between 50 to 100 grams of each. Another main item, specially for South Indians, is tamarind. You can buy half a kg of tamarind, or if you are more comfortable with tamarind paste, buy a packet of tamarind paste. And of course, the most important item is your salt and also about 50 grams of black pepper. Next, we need some spices when we make some special items or for your masala chai. So for that, I have taken cloves, cinnamon, cardamom, bay leaf and fennel seeds or sonf. Sometimes all these come together as one whole packet containing a little bit of each. Or you can just buy say between 10 to 50 grams of each. Then a small packet of baking powder. Add in some jam also on days when you want to eat it with bread or chapatis. Jaggery and honey. In dry fruits, some cashews, almonds and raisins. All these things, keep it in stock in the first month. And as I said, subsequent months, depending on your consumption, you can again replace. Again, Indian vegetarian cookery requires a lot of masalas. Basic masalas which we use in the kitchen in our spice box. That is turmeric powder or haldi, chili powder, jeera powder, dhania powder. But I prefer to buy this dhania jeera powder if it is available together as a packet, or you can buy them separately. Then sambar powder. One of the videos I will show you how to make it at home. But as beginners, you might prefer to buy it off the shelf. Garam masala. Then appalams or papad. Pickle, a small bottle if you are fond of it. Then some ginger garlic paste. And finally, I have also added one packet of any ready mix if you are used to that. For example, I like to keep rava idli mix handy, so that when suddenly some guests come or I don't have time and I'm in a hurry, I want to cook up something in a very short time, I prefer using this rava idli. So you can also keep this handy. Now, apart from all these groceries, for running the household, there are many other items which we need. For cleaning items, for example, you need floor cleaner for mopping the house. You need a dishwashing item, that is either you can take it as a liquid, bar or in powder form. Soap powder for clothes, soaps for personal use, toilet cleaners, garbage bags, shampoo, toothpaste, cosmetics. Of course, this Again, personal use, your perfumes, your deos, talcum powder, shaving cream, whatever, you can jot it down over here. Then finally, I have kept as general items. Here we have biscuits, some murmura or puffed rice, which can be made into snacks very easily, and a few namkeen snacks. Now these are for your puja or even for your kitchen matchbox. Cotton wick for lighting the lamp, some camphor, agarbatti. Apart from that, today's modern world, people like this, so I've also added noodles and pasta. So
this is quite an exhaustive list which I've given you. What I would like to suggest is you can make a copy of this list and paste it on your fridge or the inside of your kitchen door or cupboard or wherever, whichever place suits you. And then whenever you go shopping, just look at the list, take up the items, check out whatever you need, and make a copy of only those items and carry it with you to the supermarket. So this way, this helps your grocery planning a lot and it will be much more organized. So try it out and do your shopping in a very organized and efficient way so that you don't forget things and you don't repeat things. This way you'll be able to buy things possibly in a sale also when you go on the first week, say either on the 1st or 5th, whatever. So you allocate a particular day of the month for doing your shopping. I hope you find it useful and do come back to Geeta's Kitchen for many more useful videos. Thank you.